In this video, I'll show you the proper way to create a YouTube channel. Done right, this will not only help you grow your channel, but also protect your account from potential hacking. First of all, you'll need a browser. I personally use Brave, so I'll open that. In the search bar, type YouTube and click on YouTube.com from the results. This will take you to the YouTube homepage. At the bottom, you'll see an icon called You. Tap on it. Since I'm not signed in yet, it asked me to sign in. But before that, let me give you a quick tip. If you're completely new to YouTube, I strongly recommend creating a brand new Gmail account. Why? Because YouTube gives a bit more priority to new accounts, which can help boost your channel. Plus, it reduces the risk of your channel getting hacked. So instead of using my old Gmail, I'll create a new one. Tap on Create Account and choose For Personal Use. Now enter your first and last name. Important note, don't use your future channel name here. Your Gmail should be totally different from your YouTube channel name. This way, hackers won't be able to guess your login details. For this example, I'll type Jacob as the first name and Smith as the last name. Then click Next. Here, you'll need to enter your date of birth and gender. Just be honest, but remember, if you're under 18, you might face some limitations. In that case, you can use a parent's or family member's birthday, who is 18 plus. After that, click Next. Now choose Get a Gmail address instead. Enter your Gmail address. Some usernames will already be taken, so try different combinations until you find one available. For example, I'll go with JacobSmith01234. Click Next. Next comes the password. Please don't use something weak like password 1234. That's the easiest way to get hacked. Create a strong password with a mix of small letters, capital letters, numbers, and special characters. And of course, remember it. Once done, click Next. Google will now ask you to confirm you're not a robot. Enter your country, then add your phone number. You'll receive a verification code by text. Copy that code and paste it here. Click Next. For recovery email, you can skip it for now. Accept the terms and click I agree. Great! We just created a new Gmail account and signed into YouTube. Now remember, don't use this Gmail account to sign up for any other services or websites except YouTube. And if you want, you can also use it for VidIQ, since it's YouTube certified and helps with channel growth. Now again at the bottom, tap on the U icon. You'll see your name, Jacob Smith, and below that, an option that says Create a Channel. Tap on it. Here, type in the name you want for your channel. For example, I'll use Daddy as the first name and Joke as the last name. So my channel name will be Daddy Joke. At first, it might look like nothing happened. Don't worry. Just close the browser and reopen YouTube. When you tap the U icon again, you'll see that the Daddy Joke channel has been created. Now click View Channel, and from there you'll see options like Customize Channel and Manage Videos. To unlock full customization, tap the three dots at the bottom of Brave, then check Desktop Site. This will give you access to YouTube Studio, where you can set up your channel properly. Finally, click Customize Channel, and a welcome box will appear. Click Continue, and now you're inside YouTube Studio. From here, you can customize everything. Your profile picture, banner, and overall look of your channel. At the top of your channel, you'll see a banner image, and just below that, a profile picture. Let's start by uploading a profile picture. This image will appear under every video you upload. Click on Upload, allow Brave to access your photos, then choose the picture you want for your channel. Once it's uploaded, you can adjust and crop it as needed, then click Done. Next is the channel handle. A handle works like a unique ID for every creator. For example, there might be many channels named Mr. Beast, but the handle tells you which one is real. You can even find a channel directly by searching YouTube.com at handle. So here, I'll customize mine to something easy to remember, like at Daddy100Joke. Now let's set up the banner image. This part is very easy. Open a new tab and search for Canva. If you're not logged in, sign in first. Once you're inside Canva, type YouTube in the search box, and from the suggestions, choose YouTube Banner. Canva has tons of ready-made templates. Pick one you like. For example, I'll choose this template. It comes with a stock photo, but I'll delete that. At the bottom, click on the upload icon, then upload files, then choose device. Allow access to your media. Then pick the same image I used for my profile picture. Once uploaded, simply click on it and it will appear in your banner design. Adjust the picture until it looks good and then edit the text. I'll replace it with my channel name, Daddy Joke. I'll also remove the extra tagline below. When you're happy, click the download button at the top, choose your settings, and download the banner. Once it finishes, open it to make sure it looks good. Then, go back to your channel customization page and find the banner image section. Here, click Upload and select your new banner, adjust it if needed, and click Done. Congrats! Your channel now has a banner. Now, scroll down a little to the description section. This is important because when you apply for monetization, YouTube staff actually read this part. Write clearly what your channel is about. For example, since I'm making funny videos, I'll write, I love to make funny videos to entertain people. You can also add any extra details that reflect your channel's purpose. Below that, you'll see the links section. This is where you can add your social media, like Facebook, Instagram, or Discord, so viewers can follow you on different platforms. Adding links can improve your channel's growth. For example, I'll add my Discord link here. In the link title, I'll write Discord, and in the URL field, I'll paste my invite link. I'm gonna add my business email here too. That way, if any company wants to collab or promote something through my videos, they can easily reach me. Right below, you'll find contact info option. You have to add your business Gmail here. This is important as I told you, if any company wants to collab or promote something through my videos, they can easily contact me through this Gmail. I'll just drop the same Gmail address. Finally, we have the video watermark. This is a small image that appears on all your videos, usually in the corner, to identify your content and prevent others from reusing it. Upload the same picture you used for your profile, adjust it, and click Done. You'll see three options for when the watermark should appear. I recommend choosing entire video so it's always visible from start to finish. At the top, you'll see two sections, profile and home. We've already set up the profile tab, so now let's move on to the home tab. Here, you'll find a toggle button. Make sure to switch it on to enable the Home tab. Once enabled, you'll see several layout options. Click on Add section, and the first option you'll notice is the Channel Trailer. This is a video that will always play on your channel's homepage whenever someone visits. Since I haven't uploaded any videos yet, it won't work right now. Later, I'll upload two videos and show you how the Channel Trailer and Spotlight settings actually function. For now, let's go ahead and add the other available sections so that the channel looks more professional. Once everything is set up, you'll see a publish button at the top. Click it to save your changes. After publishing, if you click View Channel, it might look almost the same for now since no videos have been uploaded yet, but the layout is ready and in place. Now I'm back in YouTube Studio. At the bottom of the page, you'll find the Settings button. Click on it to open the settings menu. Under the General tab, you'll see the currency option. I'll leave it as it is. Next, go to the Channel tab. Here, you'll find the option to select your country. It's always recommended to choose United States, USA, no matter where you live. Why? Because selecting the USA ensures that all of YouTube's features are enabled for your channel. And when new updates are rolled out, you'll usually get access to them earlier than in other countries. After that, you'll see the keyword section. Whatever you type here will automatically be added as keywords for all of your videos. In this section, I'll add my channel name along with keywords that are relevant to my channel's content. Now, click on Advanced Settings. Here, you'll see the option to set your channel as Made for Kids. If your content is specifically for children, select Yes, it's made for kids. If not, select No. Next, there's the Automatic Caption section. We don't need to make any changes here. Under Advertisements, you'll notice an option to disable interest-based ads. Do not check this box because if you do, ads will stop showing on your videos. Then, in the Clip section, I'll allow viewers to clip my content. Finally, under Third-Party Training, you have the option to check the box, but it's generally recommended to leave it unchecked. Now let's move on to feature eligibility. The first option, standard features, is automatically enabled by default. The second option is intermediate features, which is very important. By enabling this, you'll be able to upload videos longer than 15 minutes and also use custom thumbnails. Many people forget to enable this feature because shorts don't require thumbnails, but whether you're creating shorts or long-form videos, you must enable it. To do this, click on Verify Phone Number. Select your country, enter your phone number, and click Next. Google will then send you a verification code. Simply copy the code, paste it into the box, and hit Submit. Once done, your phone number will be verified, and when you return to the feature eligibility page, you'll see that intermediate features are now enabled. Finally, there's the third option, advanced features. This one is required for monetization. Once you reach 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours, this feature is automatically enabled. You don't need to do anything. However, if you want early access, you can click on Access Features. There are three ways to enable it. 1. Upload a 6-second verification video. 2. Provide a photo of your ID. 3. Use an existing channel history, if available. It's best to avoid the 6-second video option since many users face issues with it. The safer choice is to upload your ID. That said, if you don't enable this feature right now, it won't affect your channel in any way. That's why I'll leave it as it is for now. Now let's go to upload defaults. The first option you'll see is the title box. Whatever you type here will automatically appear in the title of every video you upload. Since titles are usually different for each video, I'll leave this blank. The most important section here is the description. If you've noticed, big creators often have long descriptions that include details like their email, social media links, and other common information. Instead of typing that in for every video, they add it here so it automatically appears in all uploads. In my case, I'll add my business Gmail address and also include hashtags like my channel name number Daddy Joke, along with other related hashtags. Next, in the visibility option, it's very important to select unlisted. Why? Because this gives you enough time to review and make changes to your title, description, and thumbnail before making the video public. Another benefit is that setting your video to unlisted initially can sometimes help avoid copyright claims. In the tag section, you should add your channel name and a few keywords related to your content. I'll just add 3 to 4 keywords here, and these will automatically appear in the tag section of every video. Now, move on to advanced settings. By default, you'll see automatic chapters enabled. I recommend unchecking this box because automatic chapters can make mistakes. Instead, I prefer to manually add my own timeline in the description. It's more accurate and gives viewers the exact breakdown I want them to see. Next, let's move on to language and caption certification. Here you can select the primary language of your videos. Since I make my videos in English, I'll choose English. You should select whichever language you use for your content. There's also an option for title and description language. Again, I'll set this to English because my videos are in English. Now, under the comments section, you can choose whether to turn comments on or off for your videos. I prefer keeping the comments section open since it helps with engagement. You can also moderate comments by filtering harmful or inappropriate ones. I'll just set this to basic moderation. After that, there's the option to show or hide likes on your videos. If you uncheck the box, viewers won't be able to see how many likes your video has. This can be useful for shorts because if people see very few likes, they might skip your video. However, since I focus on long-form videos, I'll leave the box checked so viewers can see the number of likes. Next, we have the permissions section, which we don't need to change for now. In community moderation, you'll find settings for live chat messages. Just keep this set to basic. There's also user management, which isn't necessary at this point. Finally, under agreements, there's nothing to update right now. Once everything is set, click on Save. After that, click on the dollar icon, which will take you to the monetization page. Here, you'll see a button labeled Get Notified. Click it. This way, YouTube will notify you as soon as you meet the monetization requirements. At the very end, you'll see an audio icon. Click on it. This opens up YouTube's audio library, where you'll find tons of free music you can safely use in your videos. You can use any track from here for as long as you want and even combine multiple songs in one video. You'll never get a strike or copyright claim. The important thing to remember is, if you need background music, always use tracks from this library. Yes, there are plenty of free music options on YouTube itself or sites like Pixabay, but there's no guarantee you won't run into copyright issues. So don't take the risk. Stick to YouTube's own audio library and you'll be completely safe. So now, I've uploaded 2 long videos and 1 short video just for demonstration. Even with these uploads, my channel still doesn't look as professional as I'd like. To fix that, I'll click on Customize Channel. From there, go to the Home tab and click on Add section. First, select Channel Trailer and choose one of your videos. This will be the video that automatically plays on your channel's homepage whenever someone visits for the first time. Next, click Add section again, but this time select Spotlight. Here, pick another video. This one will be shown to people who are already subscribed to your channel. Once that's set, click Publish. Now, if you visit your channel, you'll see a video featured on your homepage, giving it a more polished and professional look. I am not done yet. Go to the YouTube homepage. At the top right corner, you'll see your YouTube logo. Click on it, then select Google Account. By default, it opens on the Home tab, but you need to switch to the Security tab. Scroll down a little and you'll see the option for 2-step verification. Click on it. You'll be asked to enter your password. Type it in and click Next. Now you'll see a blue button that says Add Phone Number. Click on it, select your country, and enter your phone number. Then click Next, and finally, Save. From now on, whenever you log in on a new device, Google will send a verification code to your phone. This means even if someone knows your Gmail password, they still won't be able to access your account without that code. In short, enabling 2-step verification makes your YouTube account almost impossible to hack. I've given you everything you need to set up your YouTube channel. If you can't remember it all, just save this video to your YouTube library, watch it again, like, and subscribe. And if you want to learn the right way to upload shorts, then watch this video.